What would you do if your TV remote runs out of battery? Do you charge it? No, you simply swap in new batteries.
Nice.
But if you are rich, you can have your butler charge spare batteries for you and swap them into the remote when needed. Coincidentally, NIO gives you exactly the same experience with their cars. And NIO calls them battery swapping stations. They already got more than 200 of these running in China and 300 more to come this year. Also, they're coming to Europe as well, starting from Norway this year. The surprise don't end just right here. Recently, NIO has just brought the second-gen station online in order to address most of the limitations of first-gen stations, but with the consequence. As NIO gains popularity, so do its battery swapping stations. In order to serve more NIO vehicles, the second-gen station can contain and charge 13 batteries at the same time compared to 5 in the first-gen. According to NIO, the swapping capability for the second-gen is 312 batteries per day compared to 120 for its predecessors. So what a leap, right? Actually, if you divide those numbers by 24 hours, then you get 13 and 5 respectively. Then it becomes obvious that both the swapping stations is designed around an 1 hour full cycle time frame. This makes sense because if the line is longer than 1 hour, charging your NIO at a charger will start to make some sense. And NIO does it for free for the customers who are not willing to wait for the swap in the case of first-gen stations. Having more battery storage isn't enough to speed up the process though. The second-gen station now has underpath for 2 batteries compared to only 1 in the first-gen. As a result, the new design cuts the wait time between unloading and loading significantly. Now, the ride-sharing is bringing changes to personalized mobility services. The exclusiveness of owning a car is now the ride-sharing is bringing changes to personalized mobility services. The exclusiveness of owning a car is getting more and more important. In the first-gen station, you have to let the station staff drive the car up the station for obvious safety reasons. This can be a little intrusive because you have to let somebody else drive your car. And on top of that, you have to wait outside of your car until the battery swap is finished. So when the weather gets really naughty, it's kind of uncomfortable for you. But NIO did not choose to ignore this issue, right? So how did they manage to do it? It's pretty simple. They sent an OTA update to your car so that it can automatically drive into the second-gen station without you having to get off the car the whole time. That's smart, right? So let's go check it out. To our left is the second-gen swap station, and you can see that the design has been renewed and it looks a little bigger than the first gen. And you can see those white markings in front of the battery swap station. They are not actually painted on the ground, but they are actually steel plates embedded into the ground. Trust me, they are big enough so that beginner drivers can really easily park into the place. And after that, you can just let the car drive itself into the battery swap station. Okay, so after we click on this button, the car will be starting to back up itself into the station. Let's check it out. I'm not touching. It's doing itself. Okay, now we are inside the second-gen station. The mechanically adaptable floor automatically pre-aligns the car before it's slightly lifted in preparation of unlocking the battery. The unlock process takes 31 seconds, including scanning, aligning, and unscrewing 10 bolts, patented by NIO as bio bolts. These complicated yet very sturdy and durable bio bolts can support up to 10,000 times of battery swaps. According to an experiment done by NIO, the battery can still stay in place even with only one of these bolts in place. Safety is a huge concern for NIO second-gen battery swap station. Speaking of which, Each battery is individually thermally managed at a constant temperature of 22 degrees Celsius to optimize charging. On top of that, there are even water spray systems in each battery bay should there be any overheating problems. And the second gen station itself is a state-of-the-art piece of engineering. With 200 plus sensors and 21 TOPS of computing power to ensure the safety and efficiency of its service, the quality of which is the basis of BaaS or Battery as a Service. BaaS is a win-win for NIO and its users, for it not only lowers the initial cost of ownership but also separates the ownership of the battery itself. Not to mention that battery swap is by far the fastest way of regaining range for an EV. So what's so special about it? As batteries take up a huge cost of EVs and degraded batteries tend to bring down the residual value of the car, now the cars have less initial cost of ownership and will hold their price better when sold as a used car. As I said earlier, NIO has already put more than 200 stations in the grid, and this number will reach 500 by the end of 2021. Currently, the second-gen stations are still staffed, but their hardware is designed to be capable of unattended operation, which is crucial in NIO's European market, as labor costs there are a huge factor. There are a few drawbacks the battery swap station would face. One is their longevity, that's obvious. And more importantly, the location is crucial. It is not that there is no space left for it in the city, but the power capacity needed to maintain a second-gen station is about 1,250 kilovolt ampere, three times the first-gen's requirement. You don't have to know what this number means, but you need to understand that that much electricity is not available everywhere, especially when there are already charging stations like Tesla superchargers in the vicinity. So setting up battery swap stations or charging stations is much like a turf war. In this case, the players do not sell drugs, but EVs. Yes, those facilities are even associated with the local sales of the EV brand they belong to. Just like communities are expensive around a good shopping malls or a school. NIO plays this out smart by aligning with Sinopec, China's one of the largest state-owned top gas station brand and a furniture retailer, Red Star McLean. Yeah, we can now swap batteries while checking out furniture or watching people adding remnants of dinosaur poop in their gas tank. Oh, by the way, models with battery swapping are eligible for full amount of EV subsidy in China, which is normally limited for EVs priced lower than about $46,000 in China. So this is another non-technical upside of battery swapping. So what do you think of battery swapping and BaaS as a business model? Leave your comments below and I will see you guys next time. Bye. I really like NIO, but I don't know why it took me through the airport for no reason. It's kind of weird.